Let's talk about the history of tennis today. What's the history of tennis? So tennis started around 12th century in France. It was called jeu de paume. It was played by the palms with a ball. Yes, you heard me correctly. It was played by the palms with a ball. And around 15th century, rackets were invented. The initial rackets were made of wood and the gut of a sheep. Yes, you heard me correctly again. The gut of a sheep. And after that, around 16th century, this game came to England and it became quite popular by that time. And Henry VIII, the King of England back then, organized the first jeu de paume tournament in the year 1740. And the popularity of this game was increasing day by day. And in the year 1839, the world was introduced to the inventions of Charles Goodyear. He invented vulcanized rubber, and hence a tennis ball was born, which was made of rubber. In the year 1873, Major Walter Wingfield brought this game to grass. Initially, this game was played on clay and he brought it to the grass, the lawns, and he named it Svastike. And in the year 1877, the All England Lawn Tennis Club organized the first Wimbledon Lawn Tennis Championships. And Spencer Gore won the first edition of the Wimbledon. Only the men's event was organized in those days. And he won a prize money of 12 guineas. Well, that might have been a big amount in those days. And in 1881, the world's second biggest tournament, the US Open, was played for the first time in New York. It's still played in New York and it's also known as the American Open. 10 years after that, in 1891, the world's third biggest tournament, the French Open, was played for the first time. It's also known as Roland Garros. And in the year 1905, the fourth and final Grand Slam, the Australian Open, was played for the first time in Australia. 5 years prior to this, in 1900, the first Davis Cup was played. This is a tournament where only men play. It's a men's tournament. Though singles and doubles matches are played in this tournament, but it's played in a different format. The players represent their countries, and one country competes against another country. And few years after that, in 1913, the International Tennis Federation was founded, the ITF, as we call it. It's the supreme tennis body in the world. And many years after that, in 1963, like Davis Cup, a team event for the women players was started, known as the Federation Cup, the Fed Cup, where the women players, like their male counterparts, represented their countries. And in 1972, the Association of Tennis Professionals, the ATP, was founded. It's an association of male tennis players. And shortly after this, in 1973, like the ATP, an association of the women tennis players was founded, known as the WTA, Women's Tennis Association. This concludes the journey of the last 800 years old history of tennis.